You've stopped contacting your spouse, and now you're trying this thing called no contact to try and get your spouse to see what they are missing so that they will want you back and that they will come crawling back to you. Or at least that's what you've heard. And now you are spending so much time trying to understand, where is my spouse in no contact? What are they thinking right now? How do I know that no contact is working? And it's taking up all of your time, all of your energy, and all of your mental effort. You're wondering if you're doing it right. You're wondering if it's working and what signs you can look for to make sure that it's working. But here is the thing. No contact is a complete sham. And I'm telling you this because you deserve to know the truth about what the concepts are that are behind the theory of no contact, why it doesn't work, and what you should do instead. My name is Kimberly Beam Holmes, and I'm the CEO of Marriage Helper. At Marriage Helper, we have helped tens of thousands, if not more, of couples and individuals to restore and save their marriages. I also have my master's in psychology, and I've been practicing in this field for about a decade now, if not more, of real hands-on experience. I study research, I make sure that it works in the lives of people that I work with before I teach it to the masses, and I make sure that it is applicable, logical, and implementable, and that it goes along with an ethical beliefs and value system. I feel the need to tell you all of that because there's a ton of people out there who really just want your money, and they will give you false promises and false claims because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter to them. At the end of the day, it matters to me. What I say to you and what you hear from me matters. I want to tell you the truth. I want you to know everything about what you're getting yourself into, and I want you to do the best possible things for your relationship possible in order to make it work. So if you study no contact and where it actually stems from, where the basis of it has originated from, it goes back to a theory in psychology that's called the reactance theory. It's all about perceived freedom. So the concept behind reactance theory is that if I'm going to lose a freedom that I have in my life or a perceived freedom that I have in my life, then I'm going to react to that in a way that's negative. I don't want, as a human being, freedoms to be taken away from me. Therefore, when I see that that freedom is being taken away, I'm going to fight to have it back. It's an interesting concept. So the theory behind it comes from, if you as an individual were to take away the freedom from your spouse to talk to you, then they are going to realize that it is a freedom that they have missed in their life, that they no longer have access to it, and therefore they're going to fight to get that freedom back. That is where no contact comes from, but it's a bastardization of the psychological principle. Let me explain what that means. So if I were to tell you, don't think of a pink elephant, the first thing that you think of is a pink elephant. It's this whole thing like, don't think of Abraham Lincoln, and then you think of Abraham Lincoln, right? That's the kind of where reactance theory comes from. If I tell you you can't do something, then your automatic urge is going to be to do it. But here's where it starts to get interesting. The more you understand about the brain and psychology, and even if you go deeper into reactance theory, is you realize that there's two parts that make this work. The first part that has to make this work is the individual who is losing the freedom has to care about that freedom. So if someone were to tell me that I could never eat fast food again in my life, I would legit not care. Not one bit. Because I don't care. I don't eat it anyway. It's not something I care about. And honestly, even if you mandated me to never do it, cool. I'm good with that. Even though I would be losing a freedom, it's not a freedom that I care about. On the other hand, if you were to tell me that I could never go outside again for my morning walks or do my workouts in my gym, I would lose my damn mind. That is everything to me. It's a freedom I deeply, deeply care about. So what's interesting when we think about no contact and reactance theory in this way, it's taking the perception that your spouse cares that they're not going to hear from you anymore. Please don't mishear me. I'm not taking this lightly, and I know that I might be sounding rude as I say it, but most of the time, if your marriage has gotten into a situation where you're at the point where you're trying something like no contact, then that typically means that your spouse is so disengaged, that they so want out of the relationship, that things have gotten so bad that the majority of the time, your spouse probably isn't going to care that you're trying this thing called no contact on them. In fact, they may be welcoming the break and the silence. And I don't say that lightly. What I want you to hear behind this is no contact is a type of manipulation at its core. In fact, if we look even deeper into how reactance theory is actually used when it's talked about in psychology, you see the warnings of it. Businesses take on reactance theory and study it as what not to do to their customers, because what they realize is customers don't like feeling pressured. They don't like the feeling of a freedom being taken away. And so it's used more as a warning of here's what you shouldn't do, as opposed to here's what you should do in order to manipulate someone into doing what you want them to do. It's not the way that you want to save your relationship, and it's not going to work. I want you to be in a place where your spouse wants to hear from you. I want you to be in a place where you get your relationship back. But if you're using gimmicks and manipulative tactics, such as no contact, to get that to happen, I'm warning you, the results are not going to be what you want them to be. At its core, reactance theory is all about taking away someone's choices and taking away their freedoms. And the results of doing this will absolutely make someone angry. If your spouse knew that you were using this as a tactic on them to get them to do what you wanted them to do, the way you wanted them to do it, when you wanted them to do it, how do you think they would react? The result is that it makes the person angry. Why? Because they feel controlled. At the very basis of no contact, it is a way to try and control another person, and it is not what constitutes or compromises what makes a healthy relationship going forward. When you have a healthy relationship, you don't use gimmicks like this in order to get your spouse to agree with you or in order to get them to talk to you when they don't want to talk to you. You figure out how to be there for them and listen to them and be an always present person in their lives. That is what ends up making strong relationships, not using bastardized versions of psychology. And that is the number one reason that using no contact is ruining your chances at saving your relationship. Because at the heart of it, not only are you pushing your spouse away, but you're making them feel controlled. And even if they don't feel that right now because they don't know that's what's going on, this is how you are programming yourself to be as a spouse. And it's not good. And it's not healthy. And you are better than that. I believe it. I believe that you have pure intentions and a pure heart, and you are wanting to do the best thing that you can to save your relationship. And I want to help you do that. But to do that, I want to teach you what actually works in helping to move your relationship forward. But there's two other reasons that I want you to be aware of. First, of why you shouldn't be using no contact and how it can be ruining your chances at saving your relationship. The second reason that no contact isn't going to work is because it assumes that the other person cares that you have stopped talking to them. And most of the time, as I said before, if you're in this situation, then your spouse may be welcoming that silence and welcoming that break. And honestly, the silence isn't necessarily good either. Because the other part about reactance theory that they also don't teach you is that when a person feels like one of their freedoms has been taken away, then the natural human instinct is to look for the next most attractive available freedom. So what is there that I can turn to next? If this has been taken away from me, okay, how can I cope with that? Let me find something to replace it with. So if you've gotten to a place in your marriage where your spouse is going to welcome the silence, then no contact isn't going to work for you. Nor do I think you should try it anyway. There are other things you can do that are much better in trying to contact, communicate, and save your relationship at this point. But no contact is not one of them. The third reason that no contact isn't going to work and is probably going to damage your ability to save your relationship is something that they don't teach you. When a person sees or finds that one of their options or freedoms is being taken away from them, then they tend to navigate towards and look for the next available option. The next less restrictive option becomes more attractive to them. So if you're withholding your comfort, your companionship, anything from your spouse that they may be needing from you in any given moment, then it gives them an opportunity to find that in someone or something else. And I don't think that's what you're wanting to happen. So you want to stop talking to them? Great. But just realize it is a chance for that person to find comfort and companionship from someone else. You may be thinking, but Kimberly, my spouse is already getting that comfort and companionship from someone else. So if I stop talking, then how is that going to make any more of a difference than what's already happening? Here's the thing. We've already mentioned we're not using this as a manipulation. But if we look at what actually works in creating strong relationships and in having healthy and long-lasting marriages, it is the ability for someone to know that the person that they love is always going to be there for them. Your spouse may be doing some terrible things right now. They may be involved with people they shouldn't be involved in. They might be saying and doing things that you never thought they would do. But at the heart of it, I have to ask you this question. Is your spouse a good person who is doing a bad thing? Or is your spouse a bad person who's doing a bad thing? If they truly are a bad person doing a bad thing, then you have some difficult decisions to make in the future. But the majority of the time, our spouses are good people who are right now involved in bad things. And even though it's hard, what is going to make change happen in our relationship is giving unconditional love, even when the other person doesn't deserve it. It's being there to talk to your spouse if they call you in the middle of the night, even if they're in the middle of an affair, listening to them. You're not condoning what they're doing. You're being there so that when they do finally wake up, that you will be that person that they remember was there for them in the worst of times. In our marriage vows, we said, for better or for worse. Right now, you're going through the worst, and I am sorry for your pain. But don't buy into things that won't work long term and have more potential to damage your relationship. Do the things that actually work. At Marriage Helper, we want to help you. We have coaches that are amazing, that know exactly what you need to do and can guide you through how to navigate the situation that you're in. How to implement what we teach with smart contact, which is our way of communication and contact with your spouse that works. And it builds healthy relationship behaviors within you as well. We have online courses to help you save your marriage. Our Save My Marriage course is amazing at teaching you the principles that are based in research and tested in the lives of thousands of people that work. It changes lives. We have our Marriage Helper workshops that you can do as a solo spouse or that you can do with your spouse, even if they want out of the marriage, that have a 3 out of 4 success rate at saving marriages. We care. I care about you. I care about your marriage being saved. And I care about you becoming the best individual possible. You can find out more about how we can help you do that by going to marriagehelper.com. Or you can give our office a call at 866-903-0990. Let us help you save your marriage.